Okay, after taxation services, client is going to ask you to provide certain internal audit services. It is like previously it was happening that external auditor was giving internal audit services to their clients. These will call non-audit services. So should audit firm provide these services? Yes, audit firm can provide these services, but they should not assume management responsibility. Okay, what are management responsibilities? These 4 plus 3, these 7 points are considered as management responsibilities. Like, they will not act at strategic position, they will not define strategies for internal audit department, that is the management work. They will not take any responsibility for the actions of internal audit employees. They will not make recommendation on internal audit activities, that these should be implemented or these should not be implemented. Okay, they should not report internal results of internal audit activities to those charged with governance on behalf of management. Okay, performing procedures that are part of internal control. So they will not design, implement, and they will not take any responsibility for designing and implementing and maintaining of internal control. They will just do certain administrative works, and for those works they will also take management approval that management is responsible for all these activities. If the client is public company, so and they should not provide internal audit services to public interest entities. This is called recurring internal audit services, means continuously they should not provide. If this is related to significant part of internal control over financial reporting, if that internal control is related to financial reporting, they should not provide that services. If it's related to financial accounting system, again related to financial statements, all these amounts or disclosures are material to financial statements. So the auditor should not provide these services. If auditor is going to provide these services, they have to reduce their threats up to an acceptable level. Okay, those internal audit activities, if that are permitted and they still create a threat, then they will use certain auditing safeguards to reduce that threat to acceptable level, like that using different personnel, different staff for internal audit and for external audit. Okay, taking independent review of the work done, informing audit committee of the situation if there is any problem. Now we are coming for corporate finance. Organization needs certain corporate finance services from their audit firm, okay, from their auditor. So should audit firm or auditor provide these services to their client or not? First thing you have to see this. If it is normally they should not provide, because certain aspects of corporate finance will create self-review threat that cannot be reduced to an acceptable level by safeguard. Okay, if they are going to provide certain financial corporate finance advice and that is on a particular accounting treatment or presentation in financial statement, and the audit team has reasonable doubt as the appropriateness of that threat, so if that is going to be a material amount in financial statement and auditor is also having a little bit doubt that is it reasonable or not, so this service or this advice must not be provided. And also auditor will not promote, underwrite or deal in client shares. Okay, he will not deal in clients, share issuance, promotion of those shares, underwriting of those shares. Okay, other corporate services, like what are different sources of finance? Is it bank issuing of shares, debentures, bonds? They can provide certain advices as sources of finance. What are the sources of finance? But for these things, management has to take responsibility. Okay, that they are acting on behalf of management. For IT services related to IT system, like if client wants certain IT services from auditor, audit firm is going to provide certain like accounting softwares. Okay, like other IT services, IT control related to financial reporting. If that is going to be a part of financial reporting, audit firm should not provide those IT system or services. If they are going to ask that which accounting software we should use, and auditor is going to tell them for your business QuickBooks is good, Tally is good, or you have to go for ERP, like that means off the shelf already prepared and designed softwares are there. If he is going to recommend any one of them, so this is not going to create any threat to independence. But auditor should not design software specific for their client. He should not take any management responsibility for design and implementation of those IT system. Okay. There are certain other services that audit firm can provide, like litigation support and legal services. But here they have to check it if they are not going to create any threat to independence. Because the main purpose is this: if certain advice, certain service is going to be a material or effect on financial statements, and auditor is having a doubt or is not sure about those adjustments, that either it is correct or it is not, so they should not provide those advice to their client. Advocacy threat, we will study it in our further video.